Kissing my girl, making a ham and cheese sandwich, hugging my baby, making a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, making another peanut butter and jelly sandwich. I used to always have to ride down that road. Now I was riding home one night, and right off of exit 8, which is the exit that you get off if you're going down the freeway or the shore. So right between exit 8, you gotta ride through Hightstown. And there's nothing going on in Hightstown, so those guys, all they gotta do is sit there by the side of the highway and wait for you all night long. So I got off at exit 8 one night, and I was going down the highway. And now, I knew I wasn't speeding, but I must have been going suspiciously slow. I was in this white pickup truck that I had, and all of a sudden I see these red lights in my rearview mirror. Like, I'm one of them people that I always forget my wallet and stuff. I always leave my wallet home. So I get pulled over, and a state trooper comes up. Hightstown man comes up and says, license registration? I said, I don't have my license and registration, sir. Takes my name, and he goes and sits back in a patrol car. And in about 5 minutes, he calls me back. And he looks at me and he says, "Hey, are you that rock and roll singer?" I said, yeah, that's me. That's me. And he said, "Are you the guy that you write that Born to Run song?" I said, yeah, that's me. He says, "Yeah." He says, "I got some of your records at home." I said, "You do?" He says, "Yeah. And son, you're in a lot of trouble." So he takes me in, impounds my truck, gives me a ticket, and the worst part of it was that I had to go to traffic court about a month later. And when you go to traffic court, there's all these weird people sitting there. And you can only plead, you got your chance, you can plead guilty, but nobody pleads that because they don't want to admit that they did what they did. And you can plead innocent, but nobody really pleads that either because they know that they did it. So the other thing that everybody pleads is guilty with an explanation. And that means that you did what they said you did, but they give you 5 minutes to bullshit your way out. So you know, everybody's pleading guilty with an explanation, and I'm sitting there, and this guy kind of recognizes me, and he comes up to me, and, you know, he's one of those people that, like, there's a whole lot of room on the bench that you're sitting, but he sits down, like, almost on your lap and leans into your face. You can tell he's been drinking, and you know, so finally they call his name, and he gets up in front of the judge, and he was caught doing 60 miles an hour on a residential side street. And his explanation, he told the judge that he was drunk and he thought he was out on a highway. Yeah. People, they think the judge is gonna buy it. He should have been pleading insanity. But anyway, I get up there, it's my turn, they call my name. And so I get up in front of the judge, and and I say, now, Your Honor, now this is going to sound a little wild, but let me start at the beginning. Well, I had the carburetor, baby, clean and check, with her mind broke out, she's on my back, a turbo jet, propped her up in the backyard on concrete blocks for a new clutch, plate and a new set of shocks, took her down to the car wash, check the plugs and points, well, I'm going. Jersey in the morning like a lunar landscape. Now the boss don't dig me, so they put me on a night shift. Takes me 2 hours to get back to where my baby lives. In wee hours, your mind gets hazy. Radio relay towers lead me to my baby underneath the overpass. Trooper hits a party line. Switch, good night, good luck, 1-2, power shift. When I met Juana, when she was employed behind the counter at the Room 60 Bob's Big Boy, fried chicken on the front seat. She's sitting in my lap, work wiping out her fingers on the Texaco road map. I remember Juana up on Scrappy Little Hill with them big brown eyes and make your heart stand still. show no mercy out there. A song seems like the hardest thing to do sometimes. As you get older, is make that connection again with your folks that you might have missed when you were a little younger. I remember when I was a kid that my dad to me was like something that was too hard to talk to. Seems so distant from me. There's a lot of things that in the end end up not getting said that ought to get said. It's good to try and catch a hold.